all depends. All right, so I'll call to order the March 11th meeting of the Rollinsville Select Board. Mrs. Knowles is excused for the evening. She has the flu, so I think we're all happy that, we're not happy she had the flu. I don't want that to get around. Happy that she's home resting and not spreading around, so we wish her a speedy recovery. First order of business is the approval of minutes of March 4th meeting. Are there any additions or?
Did we get the March 4th minutes?
We're going to table it and not take it up.
Okay.
Tell me what you have a chance to see. Pretty sure we did. I remember reading them.
Okay.
But we can take it up next week, not the end of the world. Community input. I don't want us to vote on something you haven't had a chance to see yet.
The problem, Mike, is that they won't go on the web until 2 or 3 days from now.
Wow, the unapproved ones can go up, right? Can we say they're not approved?
You could put draft across them.
A draft of them, I think, right?
Manage it.
We'll put a draft up somewhere.
She's going to be away next week, but we can figure it out.
All right, well, I'm sorry you'll be away, but hopefully we'll figure it out. It's not for any nefarious reasons, so anyways. Okay, community input?
No.
All right, Department of Business, George, coming up. I won't read through the list and make you read. So you had high praise, I'll start off this way for you, from the police chief last week when we were here. You had been out all night plowing for him. He said that he got lots of compliments from the staff, happy with the road, so good job.
Like that?
And you've gotten lots of praise on Facebook, someone tells me. I didn't read it, but for all the wonderful plowing you're doing on Portland Avenue, so. Oh, yeah, I won't let them, they're very happy their mailbox hasn't been taken out this year, so we'll take the praise even though we don't plow.
Yeah, we'll plow, we'll take the praise, yeah, just right. We have a bill for $1,582 from Nick for.
For the truck.
Okay. Move there.
Love to move purchase order 1563 to Mick Body Works and Truck Repair for $1,582.66 for repairs to truck one.
All right, I'll second it. So let's go through what's, let's see, how bad was it? It all had to do with the fuel line, right?
The whole fuel lines, basically, and, yeah.
All right. Good Lord.
We do have hydraulic leak on it right now. We're trying to locate that.
Okay.
Which, hopefully it's just a hose.
Hopefully that, where we, let's get some more weather in the week, right? Or beginning of next week, I guess.
Yeah, something next week.
But supposed to be in the high 40s, I don't know how much you're going to get, but still, probably just a nuisance, right?
All right, we don't need it.
All right, no, I agree. I'm tired of smell. All right, any question?
No question.
All right, so all those in favor of purchase order? So let me back up. We're in service, but we have a.
Yeah, the sand is the only thing, we're losing hydraulic fluid, so we're not using the sanding portion of it. It's a line that goes to the sand.
Okay, that's what it's just affects the sander at the moment and not.
Right, if we run the sander, we're losing hydraulic fluid, so.
Okay, no sander at the moment then, on that one. All right, so all those in favor of purchase order 1563, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? You don't want that. You want that. All right. Someday you want to see it. All right. Someday I'll get it right.
And I have a purchase order of $296.03 to Pike Industries for 2 ton of coal patch. 2.5 ton of coal patch.
You ready?
Working out better with down in Tyco, we just put stone dust in, that's lasting longer than a coal patch, so.
Move purchase order 1560 to Pike Industries for $296.03 for coal patch.
Second. So say that again, George, you want down there?
On Sligo, we're filling the holes with stone dust.
Stone dust?
And it's lasting twice as long as coal patch.
It seems to hold up as long as we don't get like heavy rain.
We get the rain, it freezes, and coal patch comes out of the holes.
Right. Well.
Can't use coal patch everywhere. I mean, the stone dust everywhere.
Yeah. I see. I know you've been busy putting it up, but I've seen it around. So, all right. Prices are doing business this time of year, so.
Yeah, all right. That's expensive. It's not a lot of beans.
No, I know. discussion of 1560? All right, seeing none. All those in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Well, thank you for what you're doing to help mitigate the pothole situation. Never easy.
Well, stone does about $10 a ton, this does, I mean, $30-something a ton.
So appreciate that too, Doris.
Do you need that?
It's quite a difference.
Yeah. Stone does, basically, used to be, they used to give it away, but now they're making money with it, so.
No, they haven't. Everyone has.
Do you want to talk about the light bulbs?
Well, do you have any other?
I don't, as far as that goes.
Okay, so we have dogway signs, we're going to table until after tomorrow, see how tomorrow goes. We'll bring it up again. I know it's been a topic of conversation online, from what I understand.
Yeah, I've seen a few posts.
I used to live on Second Street, I can tell you that it's god awful. And it's not much better up on Heritage. People just, it's mind boggling to me, but anyway, we'll get to it. We'll wait till after tomorrow. But there's probably more than one place in town that could put signs up, is what I guess my point, so.
There is one, isn't there?
There is indeed, but you got to catch the, anyway, we'll get into it. Well, let's wait till after tomorrow. Transfer station attendant position. So I understand we had someone who's moving out of state.
Yeah, he's moving to Georgia.
A little warmer, I understand, so, good for him. But he hasn't been with us very long.
No, he hasn't, and we did not pursue getting his license and stuff, so.
Well, that's good.
We waited on that. To see how things were going for a month or so, and he resigned for that, so.
Okay. All right, well then, put an ad in for that position. It was one of the full-time ones, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so we're okay with putting an ad into? All right. You have to take care of that.
I will take care of it.
All right, thank you. All right, light bulb disposal and business, right? Business use of transfer station.
We looked into what it costs to get rid of them, so I mean.
The fluorescent bulbs?
Fluorescent bulbs, yeah. And plus, we have to pay for the boxes to put them in, so it costs us about $7 for the boxes, plus a whole dirty bulbs and stuff.
Okay.
And it figures if we charge $1 a bulb, we'd be, I think, fair to everybody, you know. The mill has had a whole bunch of them they want to bring in. We want, you know, before we go any further, we want to talk to them about.
What would it cost us to dispose of?
Dispose of, yes.
And it's not on the schedule, right?
It's not a charge on this, there's no charge for.
So we should probably add that to the schedule then, if people are, especially disposing large amounts. How much, you told me earlier today, 50-something cents?
It's 58 cents plus the box.
Oh, the box, obviously, so.
Plus the box, yeah.
The cost of the box, so a dollar in staff time and all that, about breaking even, I'd say, so.
Yeah, you're not going to make a killing with it, but it's still going to cost us, it's making, recouping some of it.
And there's certain items that you're not going to make money off of, so.
Yeah. You know, and.
Light bulbs.
Yeah, we're never going to make money on light bulbs.
And it's, so the fluorescents are the ones that have mercury in them?
Right.
Right, so. Yeah, we don't want that getting into the.
Yeah, so we don't want people just smashing them.
Right.
Doing their thing, so.
Exactly. And if they do dump them, well, I understand it's the mill that wants to dispose of a large number, so they came to us, see if they could, we could.
Right.
Do it there, so they could do it there. So I understand that, appreciate them coming to us. But it opens up another sort of can of worms for us to deal with after tomorrow, basically. Everything has to happen after tomorrow, so. We won't do it tonight anyways, but conveniently. Our ordinance says that businesses cannot use the transfer station.
No, that they can.
No, they can, sorry, I got that backwards, sorry. That they can use the transfer station, but our contract with.
Waste management.
Thank you, waste management. Through the co-op.
Yeah.
Tells us that we cannot bring in commercial waste, only household waste.
Oh.
So the ordinance is in conflict. It's been the practice of every board, I think, since the inception of the transfer station, to not allow businesses, with the, I think the one exception may be the village vet, because there's literally no place for them to put a dumpster. And they bring like one bag out.
Yeah, he's not an issue.
And all the medical stuff goes to a medical company, they come pick it up, I guess, but he's the only one, so.
This does not pertain to cardboard or stuff like that.
Right.
I mean, we don't have commercially bringing in.
Like wet trash.
Trash, but.
So, but it opens up a larger conversation if we're going to bring in, allow businesses to bring certain products. I mean, they're paying for it, so it may be a moot point, but we may want to, when we add on to underwear, it says, policy review, add on the transfer station one too.
But they wouldn't necessarily be paying for, like bulky items they would pay for, but they would bring glass for free, which would still have a cost, though it's a cheaper cost than trash.
Right, so we need to revise the transfer station ordinance. Or we don't, if the policy is we want to allow them, we allow them.
Is this, but this is only pertaining to the light bulbs, or we?
Well, we, Roger's auto body brings cardboard already mailed to us, so we make money with that.
Yep.
And C and J, they've been bringing cardboard since I've been here to the transfer station, we bail it, but we make money off of that too.
Yep.
That's the only thing we see these commercial entities bring in.
Okay.
The mill has assessed about light bulbs, we actually took a load from them. And then we started looking at it, and that's going to cost us money to get rid of it, so we're going to talk to them about paying a fair share.
And from what I understand, the Mr. Pellerin is very agreeable.
Sure, I don't think it's talked to him yet, but he gave us his number and stuff to call.
Okay, in the past, he's been very agreeable.
You know, so I'm sure, to be able to get rid of them the right way, it's.
Yeah, right.
But the problem, Miles, is having an ordinance that allows businesses, but only taking recyclables, but not trash, and trying to regulate that is.
Right, it could become a problem.
Yeah.
I don't think it is at the moment, right?
I'm aware of.
The only, snafu at the moment is the light bulbs.
We have a contractor that lives in town, again, how do you regulate where he's bringing his?
That's true.
Because he's paying every time by check to dispose of his construction materials.
And you don't know where his clients.
But we don't know where he's getting all of that, I mean, not doing all his work in Rollins, I'm sure.
That's a valid point, but how are we going to, how do you track down where the?
Is that, do we make money on that, or?
On demo we do, we try, you know, and he's not bringing in a lot of stuff, but that's, you know.
But again, he's not supposed to.
Yeah.
He's not supposed to bring in stuff that's generated.
And he's paying actually with his business tax, you said, right?
He is, but he's also a resident, so.
Yeah.
It's really hard to tell him what came from his house and what didn't.
So it's, so we need to look at the ordinance.
Okay.
I mean, I guess this is just reinvigorated and reminded us that we need to look at the ordinance again, so. So I would say that I'm fine with, if you want to negotiate with the Cutter family, the mill owners, $1 for a bulb at the moment, then they're willing to pay that fine. And then we need to get into the fee schedule.
Yep, yeah, we'll give them a call and see what they want, you know, if they're interested.
Now, do individuals bring them in too?
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, we do get them from individuals, so that's, I mean, but you can't just charge certain people.
No, I agree, and I think that's right, I know. We want to be fair and equitable, so.
Yep.
But people are bringing them in, just individual families bring them in.
We get quite a few light bulbs. I mean, it's the fluorescent ones, we don't, there's nothing else we have to worry about, so.
Right, and the regular incandescent always go in the garbage, so. Maybe into the glass pile, I don't know.
No, we don't put glass.
No? You probably don't, I don't know what about people throw.
But they shouldn't be putting it in the glass.
Yeah, fair enough.
Because that's not a recyclable item.
So the only thing that would put us in jeopardy with our contract with waste management is stuff that goes on the compactor.
The MSW.
Or demo.
MSW.
Or demo.
Or demo.
Yes.
Okay.
Both. They do both.
So that's confusing to me. Like, so this one particular person is bringing, we think, maybe commercial waste.
He's a contractor.
No, he's bringing demo.
Bringing demo.
Not regular garbage, right?
He's right.
Oh, yeah. Construction demo, so he's paying for it.
He's paying for, get rid of his, I mean, you gotta have a place to bring this stuff.
Yep. I mean, you can drive it up to.
I mean, if he's doing a small job, why would you want to spend money to rent a dumpster when you can pay it to have it, you know?
I think the thing is, though, if you do a job, say, in Madison.
Yeah.
That might be a bad example, but a town X. You're supposed to bring that demolition to town X, just like if they do an outside contractor comes to Rollins and does work, they're supposed to bring it here, not to wherever they live. But again, how do you figure? The problem is you don't track them, follow them home, and
do they have to come and get a temporary permit for that?
They can.
They can.
Contractors working on behalf of residents can do that.
Yeah. Now, has it ever happened?
I don't know.
Realistically, I don't know. They're probably going back.
At least you have a place to bring it.
It's true.
We don't have none of that in Summit Woods.
Yeah.
And you're talking about, now they're gonna charge us extra for...
You should move to the side of the board.
Yes.
Like, I don't wanna move anymore.
You have to.
Enough houses.
Fair enough, I get you.
I get it. No, but I mean, now they're talking about charging the surcharge for the garbage bags to offset the $60,000 that Waste Management's charging them extra for recycling. So I told, I got into a conversation with one of the companies, and I said, you ought to start recycling.
Yeah.
You know?
They don't have any recycling over there?
Well, they do cardboard.
That's it?
They have dumpsters of cardboard down at the highway body. But Waste Management takes it, makes the money good. And they charge, and it's still overcharged.
We should run over and get it.
You wanna go over to Summit Woods and steal their cardboard? We have no problem with the city of Summit Woods, let's not do that.
No, I mean, the thing is, you know, if they were bailing it, they'd be making money instead of throwing it away.
Yeah, well, send the mayor an email. So we're good with the dollar for the bulk?
Yes.
Temporary for...
And that has to be...
The bulk, and then we'll change the fee schedule.
We'll talk to them and see what they want, if they want to do it, if they don't want to do it, so...
Right. If not, they'll have to figure out another way that... I'm sure it's gonna be cheaper to do it here than taking it somewhere else, but I don't know. Okay, do we have anything else for George?
Stores?
Who?
Stores do.
Stores do what?
If they sell them, they have to accept them.
Accept them back?
Yeah.
Light bulbs?
Interesting.
Yeah, then they'll be looking for places to bring them.
Exactly, they'll be coming back here, it'll be a vicious circle, so... Alright, anything else?
Nope.
Alright. Thank you, George. We'll have nice weather for tomorrow, so a good week, I'm gonna be out plowing, that's a good one.
We're gonna, Ed and I will be attending a meeting at...
Fire?
No.
No?
At the meeting, the trash.
Oh, NRA.
NRA meeting on Wednesday, they're gonna be talking about bailing plastics and the proper way and whatever, so... We just, it's about an hour or two, so we're gonna head over there and see that, they don't get anyone step on that, so we wanna check on that.
Great.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hey, George, how are you?
No harm.
Oh, wait, beautiful, thank you. We aim to please every once in a while.
Okay. Ready? I'm going numerical.
It's that time of year again, huh?
Okay. Neptune's Uniforms, purchase order number 1588, to purchase a bulletproof vest for the new officer, Malatech, for up to $700.
I'll move purchase order 1588 to Neptune Uniforms, up to $700 for a bulletproof vest.
Second. So we didn't, we bought one recently, but that officer's still using it, so never mind. I'm not happy with it. I know the answers.
Do we have leftover vests from...
That was my question.
Officers that...
No, we do not use, we don't transfer vests from person to person because they're fitted for the person.
Okay.
Plus, they get stinky and smelly after a while because you're wearing them close to your body in some cases and whatnot, so...
Understood.
This is the... Have you switched full-time to the ceramic plates you were talking about, or are we
no,
still in the Kevlar?
No. The consensus is the folks downstairs don't like wearing the outer vest that looks like you're ready to go to bed all the time.
Right,
they want to wear the outer vest, it's going to be this version instead of the other one.
Okay, fair enough. So, looks more like a traditional uniform.
Exactly.
Any other questions?
Yep.
All right, all those in favor of purchase order 1588, say aye.
Aye.
Aye, opposed?
All right. So you obviously made the offer to the gentleman we met last week. This is for the new
This is for the new gentleman.
Yes. And he accepted.
I hope so, I'm going to buy him a $700 vest.
Yes, he did buy the vest. He's already been cleared by the psychologist, medical's been cleared,
and he's getting ready to do the polygraph.
Perfect.
Purchase order number 1589 to the Cognitive and Behavior Therapies of Newburyport for one pre-employment psychological test and evaluation for the new officer, Malatat, for $400.
I will move purchase order 1589 to Cognitive and Behavior Therapies of Newburyport for $400 for a pre-employment psychological test.
Second. Any questions?
No.
All those in favor of purchase order 1589, say aye.
Aye.
Aye, opposed?
Purchase order number 1590 to Red Shoebarn for one pair of duty boots for Officer Philbrook and one pair of duty boots for Officer Brooks. Less a discount of $32.50 for a total grand total of $292.48.
All right. I'll move purchase order 1590 to Red Shoebarn for $292.48 for duty boots.
Second. Any questions? All those in favor of 1590 say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? All right.
I'm not sure what happened to 1591, but we're jumping up to number 1592 to Galls Incorporated for 13 of these quick clot combat gauze law enforcement versions. These are $42.99 each. We need 13, one for each employee, for a grand total of $525.88, and that will come out of your department line item. Most. The ones that we're currently carrying expired in 2017. I mean, they're still good, but so we're going to use the expired ones for training purposes.
I'll move purchase order 1592 to Galls Incorporated for $525.88 for quick clock combat gauze.
Second. There's 4 yards of gauze in high school tactics.
Wow.
It's pretty impressive, actually. That's why I wanted to see it. Like, wow, what do you get for all that money? That is impressive, actually. Mm-hmm. I take a look. Pretty cool, actually.
Hopefully it's one of those we'll never have to use.
Exactly.
Not for sure.
Yeah. All right. Any questions or discussion for 1592?
No.
All right. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? I wasn't sure what that was when you all saw you know, hold it, Ellie.
The electrician will be here Wednesday morning to change all the necessary light fixtures.
Great.
So that will be the meeting. And the last thing on my agenda is I prepared two pay proposals.
Okay.
For recommendation for the staff downstairs, depending on which budget gets passed.
Right.
Once we know tomorrow, Wednesday, which one gets passed, what I will do is I will email you the proposal, and I'll give you, you know, a few days to review it, and then maybe we can have a quick discussion Monday, or the following Monday, you know, whatever works for you folks.
Perfect.
But I'll at least give you a chance to review it, mm-hmm. and, you know, put my my reasons for doing this. So.
Perfect. Sounds good. Questions for the chief?
I don't think so.
I don't think we have anything else on the agenda for you, right? They're all clear.
Beautiful.
Yeah? Anything else for us?
So I should ask you first, I guess.
Oh, that's all we have.
Awesome. All right. We'll see you tomorrow at some point?
At some point, yeah. I'll stop. We're going to train tomorrow night, so.
I want to ask you one more thing, if you don't mind. We had the opportunity to meet with the services of Georgia tonight, I forgot it again. Sit down with the fire department staff maybe a month
before Christmas or something.
It was when Kevin passed away. We went over to see them. To see how they're doing. But all, you know, we hadn't actually as a board been over to meet with them as a staff. So we also wanted to do the same thing with the police department. We also wanted to do it for highway and all those employees, but
sure.
For them to you know, let us know what's happening, if they see things they want us to change, personnel policy, whatever it is, they're free to tell us, you know, what we're doing right or wrong or whatever. I didn't want you to, first of all, think we forgot about your department, because we just hadn't had a chance to do it. It's to sort of align with Kevin.
that leads, they meet weekly as a department. You don't do that as a department, right?
We meet once a month for a training.
Once a month, okay, and that's tomorrow?
That's tomorrow.
Okay, so now we're gonna have to wait till April, probably.
Actually, April's bad because we're actually meeting, instead of meeting at nighttime, we're meeting during the daytime during the school vacation. So we go to the grade school and do a walkthrough and do some training on building search and whatnot, anticipation of the active shooter exercise we have coming up, so.
Well, can we arrange something? Is that a huge hassle to get the staff together to meet with them, or?
Actually, we're all meeting, as mentioned, we're actually all going to the training at the fire department for vehicle operation. So that might be a good time.
Is that the one on the 25th?
25th.
Okay.
So that might be a good time to, for all of us, we have to come back here anyway. If you wanna pop back over here after the training over there.
Yeah, I mean, what we want it to be, it's not a meeting, I mean, I guess we'll all be there, but it's not an actual, we want them to feel free to tell us what they think. The good, the bad, and the ugly, you know what I mean? So, what we haven't discussed yet on the agenda, I think it's coming up next, actually. That thing starts at, what, 6:30?
Yes.
So I was gonna say, we come in at 6, have a brief meeting, then go over there.
Yep.
It's gonna last like an hour, hour and a half, maybe, I guess, if that?
Yeah, I think it's set for an hour and a half.
Hour and a half, okay, so if they're willing, I think, are you willing to come back over?
Sure.
Yep.
We'd love, we can just go downstairs, that's easier. We've got the meeting room down.
Sure. All right, I'll pass the word for folks to please come back here after training.
Okay. Hopefully, if they don't want to, we want all the guests, they don't have to come. It's really just, we wanna extend our thanks for all they do and to hear what, you know.
Well, I think that will go a long way in relations, because, you know, it's nice to have the bosses.
Yeah, well, it should have been happening. Can only speak for us here, I mean, this year, so it's something we should be doing. I mean, you guys do a lot of work, hard work for us, and you should know, I mean, we see you weekly or very frequently. But we don't get to see your officers, so very often. Unless it's a problem, and then usually not the best time, really, right? But we want them to know that we appreciate them, and then we want them to be heard, so we really do, so.
Yep.
All right, so if that'll work, that's perfect, I think.
That includes your part-timers, too?
Oh, yes.
Okay, great.
And hopefully the end of the law, sir.
Mr. Morissette is still in here?
He's still there.
He's holding on, huh?
He's got 1 year less than I do with the department.
Oh, he has 1 year less?
He's definitely still has a long, because he started in Summersworth when he was like 17 years old. An adult cadet type of thing.
Right.
They sell work for part-time, and then we scooped him up over here, actually. Actually, his dad brought him over after he brought me on, so.
I wonder if he'll remember me.
He may have had a nickname for you as a young child, but. A little extra, but you never know.
I didn't get pulled over by him, I got pulled over by him.
The tables have turned, I guess.
Yeah, that's true.
You can still get pulled over, though, so.
All right.
Awesome, thank you.
Thank you.
Good night. All right, so, we can go backwards just for a second. So the fire, under fire, Mark may be coming in, I don't know, but. We're gonna go over, we had said last week that we wanted to, in concept, go over, so. It's good they'll be there, and then that works out perfectly. We'll be able to meet with them afterwards, and that's great.
So I'll send an email to the board, so that Denise is in the loop that we're meeting at 6.
I mean, if it's hardship for her, that's, we can try to make adjustments, I guess, but. 6 o'clock will work okay for you to come in for a brief meeting?
Sure.
Mostly to sign whatever paperwork, or there's a purchase order that has to be done. A citizen has a complaint or an issue, whatever they need dealt with. So it won't be a full agenda, so. Unless we really talk quick. All righty then, so what brings us to town administration? So tomorrow's town meeting, excuse me, the town election portion at the Legion from 7 to 7. You'll be there?
I will.
And I'll be there, Denise clearly is ill, so she won't be able to make it, so. I have a call I have to be on at 5. It shouldn't last.
long, so, but.
Yeah.
So I'm available all day, it's just I, five, and they're gonna call me, so.
I gotta run out and go get my mother, so she can vote. But yeah, I'll be there for the majority of the day.
We'll be around to help whatever needs to do to help.
Perfect. All right. Non-public personnel, are we doing this now?
We can table it later.
Can we wait till the end of the?
Why don't we do that, why don't we do it at the end?
End of the meeting, so we don't have to make people come in and out.
Yeah.
I'm thinking we might be able to finish up sooner rather than later. All right, so Budget Committee Secretary position, we've extended an offer to?
Well, I was wondering if the board might like to extend an offer.
Okay, let me back up. You have interviewed, you have met with a candidate, and you were recommending someone that we can extend an offer.
Yes, yes, her name is Anna May Russo, she came in on Friday morning, and Salma happened to be working, so she got to meet her as well.
Thursday afternoon.
Oh, thank you. All my time with Salma gets sort of mushed together, but she made the time and she came in, and she was very pleasant, she's got good writing skills.
This is the person that was vetted by John Overway too?
That, yes.
Or she submitted her resume to two people, right?
Right, and he spoke with her as well, and found her to be suitable, so I think she'll be a good candidate. She's gonna, I'm gonna have her in, if the board approves her hiring, we can make that probationary period contingent upon the background check, and then have her in to do some training, and then if the board is amenable, I was hoping that we could have her fill in for Salma for the 18th, because Salma will not be here the next Monday.
What's her name, Angela?
Anna May, one word.
Anna May, yep.
Russo.
With a Y or an E?
That was an E, that's by the way.
M-A-Y, pardon? A-N-N-A-M-A-Y.
I have a 50-50 chance. Russo?
Russo.
Russo it is, okay. So, why, are you ready to vote, or am I talking about it?
Well, we need a pay rate.
Do we not, was that not?
I'm not sure if it was in the posting, but, you know, there was some discussion back and forth about it, and I did not discuss that with her.
What was the, what was the?
I think the last posting was 11, I'm not sure though, so I just wanted to confirm that and make that.
Whatever, I would say you need to, figure out what the last posting was.
Yeah, I think it was 11, all right.
Because we had to raise it a few times, right, because we weren't getting any.
Right, I'm almost certain it was 11.
I think it was 11, so.
So you don't know if she'll accept it at 11?
Well, I did offer it to her, so.
Okay.
I think she will, I think she's very excited about it, she's.
All right, so.
She'll be excited about it, so if you're amenable to 11.
All right.
Why don't we do that, if it turns out to be a different rate, we can amend that later for future.
So she, all right, let's get a motion first.
There. I'll move we extend an offer of employment to Anna May Russo for the position of Budget Committee Secretary at $11 an hour.
Okay, I'll second that, all right, so, I'm pretty sure that's what it was.
I think so too.
Where you started at 10, or 10?
Yeah, it was 10:50, I think it was 10:50, and you bumped it to 11.
Right, because we're having issues finding anyone, even at 11, we're having issues, so, all right, and the nice thing is she's also willing to fill in.
For other boards.
And is she willing to fill in or do the ZBA, did we talk to her about that?
I did talk to her about that, she seems really excited about that.
Okay.
It's gonna require, to the level at which I would like for somebody to do that job, which is to say the level at which it's been done, it's gonna require some training.
Okay.
She's gonna need to get up to speed on the regulations.
Right.
I rely on the current person to compare the applications with the regulations to make sure things seem to match and make sense.
Right.
Sending out the notice, you're creating the notice.
Sure.
Notices of decision, it is a lot more than just taking minutes.
Sure, clearly. Is there a training via the Municipal Association?
No, not really, actually.
That's unfortunate.
It is unfortunate. But it's okay, I think she's a quick learner and.
Okay.
We can handle it. I'll have Sarah step in too and show her how things specific to the zoning board should be.
Okay.
Written up, the notice of decision and.
Sarah's still staying on planning though, right?
She will stay on planning.
Okay, just not ZBA?
Correct.
Okay. Do you have any questions or concerns?
Should we amend her title from Budget Committee Secretary to like Floating Secretary?
Minute taker, just broad minute taker.
It's semantics, but.
I think we just keep her on the Budget Committee Secretary. And she's agreed to fill in when needed, but she's not being hired for that, she's being hired specifically for the Budget Committee, so. All right, are there, any other questions?
Nope.
All right, all those in favor of hiring Anna Mae Russo for Budget Committee Secretary, say aye.
Aye.
Aye, all right, thank you. Appreciate her interest. All right, department head meetings, I didn't mention it to Bob or George, but I sent them an email. I don't think either of them read it, neither of them mentioned it, but April 5th. So the meetings before were done quarterly.
Oh, okay.
So that seems to be the best way to go for now. And if they feel like they need to be monthly, we can discuss that. I'm not opposed to doing a monthly, but I figure if we're gonna start up again, maybe at least we should start it from where we were.
Yep.
So, April 5th. And I suggested in the morning to them, I'll let you all know what the response is, so. All righty. Policy review, so we're keeping welfare on as a placeholder. Till after tomorrow, I guess, to see if there's interest in any further review. And the personnel policy as well, we recognize that there may be some deficiencies there, and that we want to take a look at that. All right, town administration, well, how about that for impeccable timing, Ms. Leopold? Why don't you come on when you get to it? Because we're on recreation.
Okay.
How's that for divine providence? All right, so the first thing we have still here on here is the job description. Now, do you want to set the scene and we'll give you a second for Celia, I can catch your breath from coming in?
So Denise didn't get a chance to review these according to the salary. The job descriptions were approved by the board last week with the exception of
salary.
So I reviewed that, given the recreation budgets that you forwarded today, thank you. I subsequently spoke with Denise because there were things about budget lines that were kind of confusing. And so that's why I worded it the way I worded it. So I will walk you through the changes that I made. The first one, summer camp director, it's the only director. I changed the, instead of wage range, it says salary, it's up to $600 a week.
Right.
The budget covers that, but it gives the committee flexibility to not pay out quite that much if they don't feel the need to. And so for the salaries, I've put up to.
Yeah, that makes sense to me.
So in the summary of essential job functions, the last one I added must be available for the, you know, for all 8 weeks of camp.
Yeah, I think that's appropriate.
That was Celia's recommendation.
Last year, we had 3 to 4 staff members ask for 1 week off, and we were severely short-staffed for that 1 week.
It'll have to be the same week.
The week after.
Oh, week after.
So then Camp Raleigh Assistant Director.
Yep.
That went from a wage range to a salary of up to $520 a week. With the same, under job functions, must be available all 8 weeks of camp, no other edits.
Good, okay.
Team Camp Assistant Director. You didn't see this one last week. There was just one assistant director, but Camp Raleigh and Team Camp both have assistant directors and...
I thought we saw it, but okay.
Okay, perhaps. So we're just gonna revisit to be sure.
Okay.
I've named it specifically Team Camp Assistant Director versus Camp Raleigh Assistant Director for clarity. They are different amounts because they're different budgets.
Sure.
So the Team Camp Assistant Director is up to $400 a week. There are different hourly assumptions, hourly wage, even though they're salary, based on different hourly amounts.
Sure.
I did get your last minute, yes. But there reflects that, but I'm hoping it will go back to committee. I was operating off of perhaps an incorrect budget when I created what that up to amount was going to be. Celia sent a revised amount based on a subsequently approved budget. So this amount reflects what she said, but again, it's an up to amount, so I'm hoping the committee will revisit and make sure that the actual salary is covered by the budget and agreed upon by the committee.
But I was going to say, the committee also discussed since camp that it didn't work having two assistant directors. It makes more sense to have two directors so that the teen camp director can be independent of the Camp Raleigh director. So they would, it should be instead of assistant.
A teen camp director?
Teen camp director, the word assistant should come out of that.
Salary remains the same?
I believe so.
Up to 400?
Yeah, yes. And so we should.
So it should be director of Camp Raleigh.
So Camp Raleigh director and then a.
Teen camp director. So we changed the structure slightly.
And then teen camp director.
Teen camp director. Just cross out the word assistant. All right, you all right with that one?
Okay, and then for the summer camp counselor, I revised this. Taking for the wage range, I took out all references to dollar amounts and it just says dependent upon experience and qualifications. And yep. I did that because of my conversation with Dee, because what she said conflicted with my conversation with Denise. So I think there's still some maybe misunderstanding about how much you're actually paying your counselors, but I wanted to make sure that the board had the opportunity to get this one approved so you can. The directors are more pressing because they need to hire them first.
I would imagine if you were in your second or third year, you get a different wage
right.
than.
And the wages that were on there did not reflect accommodating people who had been here last year and probably made already above that wage.
Right.
So that's why I did that. There's also, you may potentially see a fifth job description for a teen camp counselor should they elect to. They have just one employee for teen camp, this one director. So they may, you know, they may rely on volunteer help or they may choose to hire a counselor, but I'm not submitting that job description yet.
As long as within their budget, fine.
Yeah, it is budgeted.
It is budgeted. Okay.
This one doesn't have that 8 week,
right?
The camp counselor.
It was not clear to me whether or not that was okay.
necessary
for the
because
counselors.
That is the kind of come because
we
go.
Fluctuate on the number of kids, and oftentimes okay. we do not have as many kids as
right.
we might need counselors for.
That makes
so,
sense.
And as we get closer to the summer, if they request a day off and it's a day we know we're going to be later on campers, we give them the day off and it saves us financially.
Right, that makes sense.
Good.
I was wondering that too, Andrew. That makes a lot of sense. So.
And then we also, towards the end of the summer, get into a lot of high school kids doing sports. And so if they're 16 or 17, they may want to do sports.
There you go.
Okay.
All right, so what are you looking for? You need approval for these salaries?
We need all of the job descriptions as revised.
Because we would like to get these people hired.
They're
well.
Trying to get directors from UNH, and that window
right.
is closing quickly.
So I think we can make one motion to cover all of them. All right, so I'll move that we accept the amended job descriptions for the rec position.
Second. All right, so motion is to accept the amended job descriptions for the summer recreation camps. Any other discussion?
Yeah.
All right, all those favors say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Perfect. All right, thank you. Well,
thank you very much
for that. Okay, let's talk about grant applications.
So, last year we ran into receiving grants during the summer, so we were hoping to get a jump start on it this year. We have one grantor. Granting agency that needs their application this week.
Okay.
Last year the process had been the ex officio to the committee reviewed them along with the chairs.
She's under the weather, so it's not going to work. So.
So I was wondering, do we change the process? How? And I was also made aware that the board needs to know what is coming in because the rec committee cannot accept it. It's up to this board
right.
to accept it. And so.
And to be clear, so the ex officio would review it, but it would still need to come to the full board to whether, agree to whether or not we would sign off on the grant application. But ultimately, we have to be the people making the application, so, right?
So.
Do we have it?
I have.
I know there's an email, I didn't get home in time to read.
Well, this application just got finished.
Oh, okay.
So it didn't make it into any email. I was hoping to have it finished earlier in the day.
That's all right.
This is a grant funder who's local. It's.
Oh, yeah.
And we discovered at our last meeting, or shortly prior to our last meeting, that we need a license to show videos in camp or come up against stiff lines. And so this is.
You mean copyrighted material?
Videos and music are copyrighted material. So the fines range from $750 up to, I think, $150,000.
But if you put the radio on, you're okay, right?
Yes.
You cover under their license.
That's about the license.
So we have this information about camp licenses through the American Camp Association. So we would like to apply for the 3 months summer only subscription, which is $300.
Right, and they're willing to cover it, the Rollins for Education Association?
We're asking them to help us cover it.
Okay.
Because it was not something that we included in our budget, and we hope to in the future include it in our budget.
So you're asking the Rollins for Education Foundation for $750?
$300 for this, and then $450 to take a group of campers, of roughly 60 campers, to the Colonel Paul Wentworth House.
Nice.
And it's $150 per group of 20.
Oh, right.
So that's how we end up with $450 for the total of $750. We did it in 2017, but we were unable to do it again in 2018 due to funding issues.
Gotcha.
And we only paid them $100 in 2017, and it didn't even cover their materials used. Mm. So we would like to make a good faith effort.
Okay, so let's see. Are there any financial responsibilities on behalf of the town? I don't see any.
On the bottom of page 3 and page 4, it says evaluation. How will you measure success?
Right.
Describe the evaluation tools. So I've said that we will keep track of the number of times the license is used and send out a survey to participants in the.
Right, we'll take a picture of the events. Like going up to the Wentworth House and all that, and the kids watching the movies or whatever. So that I understand, but there's no, if for some reason the grant isn't fully used, is there a responsibility to return any unused money or?
That I am not aware of.
They may not, so it's not on here, so I just want to make sure.
Everything in blue were their questions and some of the stuff in it. One of the requirements under collaboration is that everybody has a background check, which is part of our hiring process anyway.
Okay.
So.
It doesn't look, I mean, it's also a local, it's not like it's not a business, so it's.
And we did use them in 2017 for a grant.
We did, okay.
But they paid directly to the vendor.
Okay. Are they going to do that again, or?
I don't know.
Okay.
Probably be easier.
It probably would be.
So that is a question for this group, is do they pay directly to the vendor or do they pay to us?
It would be easier, I would imagine, if they paid to the vendor, no?
Yes, and if they pay the town and the town pays the vendor, then it's coming out of your budget as an expense.
Right.
Even though it has offsetting income. So for that reason alone, it would be desirable for them to pay directly.
Right, both of them. So pay the Wentworth House and the Camp America. American Camp Association.
And I do make a suggestion in the grant that if we were to get this, we would collaborate with REF or other organizations like Salmon Falls Family Fun Day to provide movies outside of the camp hours to the community, if that's applicable with this. It doesn't say that you can't do it anytime.
Well, I think, well, you mean for the American Camping Association?
Yeah.
I don't know, it's...
It probably has to be associated with rec, though.
Yeah, I think so. Well, let's look, you've got a whole...
Number...
18 different terms and conditions.
Under the last question, under questions and answers, we rent out our facility to other groups. Can we be liable for copyright infringement? Yes, the owner can be held vicariously liable or considered a copyright infringement. So... But I don't think it says that it has to be within selected hours.
I'm reading it, right, so... Okay, so under terms and conditions of this license you want to purchase, it says, under rights, a public performance authorized by this agreement shall take place in the facilities identified in the application or as licensee otherwise modifies, and shall be via any means, that's a little small.
That's okay.
Originally intended for personal use only, including but not limited to DVD, blah, blah, blah. I don't think you can.
Okay.
So I think it has to be specific to the rec department at the summer camp. I don't think you can extend a license and share, you know, I think they would have to purchase their own.
Okay.
And it does allow you to show unlimited, it says, does this umbrella license allow us to show movies outside? Yes, the umbrella license allows for unlimited indoor, outdoor exhibitions at your camp or conference center, but only at your, you know. So it's not like you can say, oh, it's family fun day, we're gonna...
But the camps kind of, does it have a specific location? Is it...
Grade school.
The grade school?
The grade school.
Is it the field at the grade school?
Yeah, we could have it on the field in the grade school because that's the camp location.
Yeah, you can have it there. You can have it inside or outside.
But you could do it at the Legion.
Or at the ball field, which somebody suggested projecting it onto the firehouse.
I mean, you might be able to if it's during the day, it's a camp activity, and then all the kids are being busted.
Right.
But if it's like at night, just a general, let's have a fundraiser and have the whole town go, you're gonna be violating this license, so...
Yep.
And it's still gonna be subject to your $750 fine, so...
I made some minor textual edits you might want to look at. They're just minor grammatical things. Thank you for doing that.
Yes.
It's good, and it's a great idea.
Are there any others besides the first page?
Yes.
Okay.
And if you want, I can make those edits and then forward it to the select board for a signature.
I mean, they're minor, so...
That would be great, especially if it could happen tomorrow, because then I can go down and get signatures easily tomorrow.
I mean, it's, oh, yeah, so you can just come see us tomorrow, so what? Come to my office. Come on over. Enjoy your ride. It's pleasant. Yes, that's true, you could just come down tomorrow. I mean, I don't have any objection to this, it seems pretty clear. With these edits, I mean, they're minor, sort of a couple of grammatical things, that's not like...
This is a great idea.
Say go forward and do it. We'll sign off on it tomorrow then?
Okay.
Do we need a, let's do a motion.
Sure. I'll move that we authorize, I guess it's the rec committee?
Yeah.
To move forward with a grant request to the Rollinsford Education Foundation in the amount of $750.
Second, any discussion? All right, all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye, opposed. All right, so we have to sign off on it though, so you're free to do it, just make the edits that Caroline suggested to you, Celia, and then she'll email it back to her and she'll bring it down at some point tomorrow. And we will sign, goodbye.
Our contact person has been Diane, the president of their organization, and the board's first email address.
Actually, you went back pages and checked it. It's just these pages.
I
couple of grammatical things on that, so.
There you go.
Still, thank you.
Could change page one to have you buying a car.
I just did that. Good luck. All right, so I will give this back to you like this and know to.
Okay, I'm gonna keep the back page and give you the C.
The one with the edits, you might wanna give to the person making the edit, yeah, sorry about that.
So, the process.
Yep.
For grants.
Yep, you bring them to us until Denise is back up. So if you have others this week or next week, if she's not back, you just bring them to the meeting and we'll.
Okay, they should come to the meeting anyways, so that you all are.
Yeah, but I'm saying you would normally forward it to the ex officio who would revise, I mean, review it and make revisions if necessary, and then forward them to us. But, yeah.
If it's possible to get them emailed ahead of time, then that increases everybody's opportunity to try to read them ahead of time.
I have less questions to work on.
Yeah.
This one's pretty straightforward.
You have many more coming?
We hope so.
We hope to help offset. Last year we applied for, I believe, 4 or 5, and we only got one. And it was $1,500, I think, or $1,000, and we used it for STEM education in the camp. We brought in the Mount Washington Observatory and a UNH student who did STEM this summer. And then we used the remaining $400 for the Doodlebugs program at the end of the summer.
Right.
It was good.
So, thank you for doing that.
Yes.
No problem.
Anything else we'll still write while you're here?
I think we're pretty good to go.
Awesome.
Trying to get staff. Oh, yes, that's the other thing. Registration opened on Friday.
Good.
And we already have 16 kids registered.
Wow, that's great.
Awesome.
13 of them are out of town, and 3 of them are in town. And they are all from Camp Raleigh.
That is where you all have earned yourselves a great reputation, apparently.
That's great. That is that.
All right, great.
Thank you, have a good night.
You too, thank you. All right, let's do building permits. Building permits, Rex Boulder.
It's so. I'm starting to fill out a building permit.
It's hard to take minutes when it's a lot of people.
We have building permit 29 Pine Street.
Right here's for sale.
Renovations of $12,500 fee. $155, looks like Mr. Clark has reviewed.
And that's with apologies. That's with profuse apologies.
Oh, okay. Interesting. Alrighty then. Where am I? Alright, so purchase order. Building permit 2019-012. By Mr. Clark, I'm just repeating exactly what you said. So it's granted, and you're out of practice here, sorry. It's not going to expire tonight. It's going to expire,
Do I have license renewal or something?
Fine. I keep already picked
mine. Nancy Diane? Do I have license renewal?
Apparently they knew you'd be here tonight. Alright, so we have signed off on that.
It's a 2019-013, 17 Highland Ave, $50,000 worth of
that makes sense.
Work fee, yes. $525, Mr. Clark has.
Thank you for following up on it. I wondered if they had a building permit for all that work they were doing. Apparently they do now. Alright, so first building permit 2019-013 has been reviewed by Mr. Clark. It's a $525 fee. All right. Just until.
Hello.
I think I know that.
We're 10 you a lot of slack tonight, Mike.
Well, the time change.
Yes.
Oh, it's really screwed, it really has screwed me up. I didn't sleep very well last night.
I didn't either.
We give them a year, right? So 6 months, rather, so it's today.
That would be September.
September, right.
Give them the 12th. September 11th, it's not good.
Whatever.
And September?
No, they can tell the 11th. I'm gonna renew it. They need to.
All right, building permits. 2019-014, 3 Highland Ave, $4,000 worth of electrical work, fees $90.
All right, then we do go to Mr. Clark.
And 2019-015, 1 Doherty Lane, $3,800 for a new roof, fees $65.
$65.
$65.
$60.
Does that say 60?
Oh, it's a new roof on a garage, by the way, so that's pretty cheap for a new roof. All right, so is that the last building permit? So why don't we take a break for a moment?
What are we gonna do with mine, because what, we have to do the work.
So why don't you, yeah, there's that, did you fill out?
As much as I could.
As much as you could.
I have the money.
Oh, that, we got the time. You got the money.
We just need a number.
So what we will do, Selma, you have submitted your request, you will have, we will put it in the folder for review, and have Clark review it, and then send it back to us. Clearly, the roof is coming tomorrow, I get it. They come when they come, I get that, so.
Tom will be in tomorrow?
No, Tom comes in next Monday.
He'll be on Monday.
So, but you'll be in, whatever day, when do you come in, Thursday?
Thursday's a Friday.
So you can fill out the, fill in like the map, lot map number and all that, if you come.
Yeah.
So it'll be, it's not gonna get acted on anyways until next Monday anyways, so we'll leave it in the folder for you to revise when you come in on Thursday, and then Mr. Clark can take a look at it.
Okay. Have a couple of purchase orders. I move purchase order 1601 to Andrea Cass for $308.25 for 2018 lien notices.
So that's really for postage, and I would suggest that we cross out Andrea's name and maybe write postmaster.
We're not sending our check, right?
No.
Unless you're second it. Then we talk about, we're not.
I'm sorry, yeah.
Unless you already paid for it, but like out of her pocket.
I don't believe, no.
Maybe.
But this is another situation where the $200 purchase policy, you know, nobody can put that on a credit card, so then you need a check for it, but she doesn't know how much it's gonna cost until that day when she's actually doing it. So I'm not sure how we're gonna execute it.
Should we do an up to amount instead?
Yeah, well, you know, that's always implied. You don't have to spend the whole thing, you know, so.
But I mean, should we?
That's not really the issue. My, you know, my issue is like.
So we need to revise, under policy review, we need to put.
Purchasing would be great.
Yeah, so we need to add.
I can add purchasing, thank you.
All right, so do we have any other questions or concerns about 1601? Clearly it's to the postmaster.
Yes.
We need to send these out because we need to send them out.
It's the day.
Yeah, it is the day. All right, there's 45 of them that need to go up. What do they cost, $685 now for certified mail? That's how they had to go up, so. All right, all those in favor of purchase order 1601, say aye.
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 Purchase order 1603 to LHS Associates for $1,891.32 for town ballots and programming.
Second.
So, this is for tomorrow's election?
Yes, the ballot's just the town portion.
I was gonna say, that was my next question, so it's just for the town.
She sent the same, it's on one invoice, but she sent it to the school.
But they got their own?
Yeah.
Well, clearly it doesn't add up to.
Right.
Gotcha. Okay. Alrighty then, any questions?
No.
Alright. All in favor of purchase order 1603, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Alrighty.
That's it for the new folder.
That's it.
You have your dispersment form.
I have my dispersment form, I'd like to get one. So it's a quarter? I can't sign, no.
Oh, I just have to sign it.
You have to sign it, I can't sign my own dispersment form, so.
And those are.
Those are bills.
To be approved.
But this is the blue folder, I'll do this tonight.
There was, oh yes, it's up there.
Well, apparently you wanna be paid too. Well, imagine that, alright. It's that time of year again.
There's four dogs to license here.
Four dogs, I'm a teacher. Alright.
Cheaper to get a kennel license.
Is this a day week?
Is this?
Oh, next week.
Next week, oh, there you go.
I will put them together then, I'll probably get to sign it, I mean date it rather.
Please. Thank you. Alright. Put them back in, yeah. Alright, this is a notice, the only thing there besides the dispersment.
Yes, it is.
A notice from the Rollinsford Zoning Board of Appeals, that we are in a butter, that on Tuesday, March 19th, there will be a session of the ZBA at 7 p.m. here in the Rollinsford Town Hall. Here the following appeals, case number 1901 of Mario Cassinelli, also known as Dave's Auto Salvage, seeking an appeal from an administrative decision in relation to section 5.2, the non-conforming use of section 6.2 use regulation to the Rollinsford Zoning Board. And case 1902, also brought by Mauro Cassinelli, also known as Dave's Auto Salvage, and he's seeking a variance from section 5.2. I don't know if I'm available to go next week, but I know we wanted the chief of police to attend and Tom.
All of the department heads and the board and Tom were notified via email and got that.
They were, okay.
So everybody is aware that Tom has confirmed he's available.
We'll coordinate, make sure the chief is also available to bring his files.
He got it via email, but I will confirm it with him.
I think is certainly was eye-opening to me, his interactions with.
What time do they meet?
Seven. Seven, I guess, here. Actually, I guess I just. Yeah, I might be able to go actually, but I think Kate has to go to South Dakota next week, so I don't know. Honestly, I can't say if I can go or not yet. I have to check in and see what we have for Chuck. But I will try to go.
I have an engagement right after work, but.
Well, I mean, we don't have a goal of the board to play. Yeah, I would like to hear it too. I'm more out of curiosity. I think the chief and Tom will handle it fine on our behalf. But anyways, if I can make it, I'd like to go myself. So, all right, I think almost to the end. We did review correspondence, board member updates. We just skipped right by that because Celia came in, but I guess we're both going to the ballot.
Yeah, there's an election.
Should I hear? All right.
That's it.
That would happen. Do you need one? 28, all right. Well, seeing none, I wish everyone well. Good luck on your election tomorrow.
Let's go to non-public.
Oh, we gotta go to non-public. Oh, aren't you good?
Good job.
All right. So I'd like a motion, please, to go into non-public to deal with a personnel issue.
Move that we go into non-public to deal with a personnel issue.
I will second that with a roll call, Miles.
Yes.
Mike, yes, we are non-public. We'll have our town administrator attend. We will be adjourning.